Are you trying to snatch your waist in 2021? Do you struggle with chichos? Do you want to find ways to wear your clothing in a way that makes you feel curvy and confident? Then girl, go ahead and sit down, buckle up, you're in for a ride. This video is just what you've been waiting for. Hey guys, it's Elise. Welcome to my channel. If you're new, thank you so much for stopping by. And if you're not new, then of course, welcome back to my channel. So guys, for today's video, this is going to be another how to make your waist look smaller, how to make yourself look curvier type of video. I did one of these, I think it was last year, and you guys seem to really like that video. So I wanted to bring you a part two. I had a couple of you guys mention that it would be really helpful to show you guys different ways that you can make your waist look smaller with clothing. And I thought that was a really good idea. I have five really good tips for you guys today. So of course, if you want to see, then keep watching. So it is very important for me to mention that in this video, I'm going to be talking about illusions. And if you do not know what an illusion is, I'm going to go ahead and define that for you. So we are all nice and crystal clear as to what an illusion is in this video. So an illusion is a thing that is likely to be perceived or interpreted by the senses. And the sense we're really talking about today is vision. So we're talking about illusions and things that you can do with your clothing to trick the eyes into making you appear a lot curvier than you might be, or maybe you're already curvy and you're just wearing your clothes the wrong way. All in all, these tips are just going to be really helpful to bring attention to the smaller parts of your body, which in turn just makes you appear a lot more curvy, which is what we all want, right? Colors. Make sure that you are paying attention to the colors that you are wearing. Light colors are going to always highlight and bring attention to those parts of your body where you are wearing the light clothing, and dark clothing, aka blacks and darker colors, are going to mask those parts of your body, right? In this first example, I'm wearing this olive off-the-shoulder striped shirt with these black pants. This is a very simple outfit. There's really nothing wrong with it. However, in terms of me wanting to appear more curvy and in terms of bringing light to the body shape that I desire to have, this is not really going to do me any justice. Why? Because for one, I have the patterns on the top of my body and I'm not really bringing any attention to my hips and my lower body and my butt, which is what I really want to bring focus to. It's really important for you to note that you can't slim your waist, okay? The waist that you have is the waist that you were given, unless you work out or unless you get surgery or unless you do something to reduce your waist physically. The waist that you have is the waist that you have. What you can do, however, is broaden your lower body, bring attention to the fact that your hips are a little wider, which in turn makes your waist look a lot smaller, right? So while this green top and these black pants, there's nothing wrong with this outfit, this isn't really bringing attention to the figure that I want to have. The striped top is just really bringing attention to my upper body. It's bringing attention to my shoulders. It's making my shoulders even look a little bit broader than they actually are. And it's really not calling that much attention to my waist. And the black pants is completely masking my lower body, appear a lot more narrow because of the fact that the black is masking and it is covering that part of my body. So when you are trying to create an illusion of a slimmer waist and a broader lower body and a wider hip area, an outfit like this is definitely a better option. So as you guys can see, in this outfit, I am wearing a black top. It's just a regular black top, and I am wearing some plaid pants. So again, the importance of patterns, right? So patterns can either really help you or they can really hurt you. So in this example, I feel like the pattern is really helping me, especially because I have these purple plaid pants. They're really busy and they really bring attention to the lower half of my body. You can clearly see the fact that these pants are really bringing attention to the lower half of my body. My hips appear wider in pants like this, and coupled up with the fact that I'm wearing a black shirt, the black shirt is going to help slim. It is going to help make me appear a lot more thinner on the top area, and it is going to mask the areas of my body that I don't want to be shown. Example, my gut. I don't really need her to be available. I do not really need her front and center right now, right? My chichos don't need those either. Love handles, they ain't there. So that's the beauty of wearing a regular black top. And a lot of the reasons, well, most of us like to wear black, and we have black in our wardrobe because it just makes us look skinnier. Yeah, so this is definitely a much more favorable outfit in terms of bringing attention to my curves. So if you're somebody who is afraid of pattern, or you just don't like a lot of pattern, or maybe you do but you're not sure how to wear it properly, maybe pay attention to something like this and make sure that you are buying the right pieces to enhance the right parts of your body. Tip number two, which is definitely a no-brainer, and it kind of goes hand in hand with the first tip, just make sure that you're really tucking everything in. I see so many girls always say that they're not curvy, but they never tuck any of their clothes in, and I feel like I just want to scream. I want to be like, girl, if you were to tuck in that shirt, put it inside those pants, you will instantly see that body yaddy yaddy that you have, that you are hiding. So it is just a really simple tip, and honestly, there's not much else to say to it. But here you can see a really prominent difference from me not tucking in my shirt. You can clearly not really see much waist definition, and then the minute I tuck in my shirt, it's like, wow, she actually has a waist. It looks nice. Not only that, but tucking in your tops also makes you look so much more polished polished. Of course, it makes you look snatched, which is what we all want. So yeah, tuck in your shirts, okay, y'all? Tip number three, we're going to talk about dresses and just making sure that you know what kind of dress you need to be wearing for your body type. So I ended up wearing just a regular skater dress. I love this dress and I've had it for about 4 years or so. I got it in H&M like forever ago, but I just will never get rid of it because I love the way that it makes my body look. It is so important for you to know what type of dress you need to be wearing for your body type. If you are not curvy, if you have a straight body type, you want to make sure that you are staying away from bodycon dresses. They will actually hurt you instead of help you because of the fact that they will bring attention to the parts of the body that you might not like. It is important to know that things like skater dresses, A-line dresses, wrap dresses, those are perfect to just really bring attention to a small waist. If you're in this video, I'm assuming you want to have a smaller waist. So of course, I wanna just make that very clear. A skater dress, A-line dress, like the one that I'm showing you guys in this example, is going to be perfect because as you guys can see, it really cinches in at my waist and then it flares out towards the bottom, which gives me a really nice feminine look. But more so than that, it's giving me that curvy hourglass type of figure that I want, right? Because it's really cupping me in at the waist area and giving me that support, but then it's flaring out at the bottom. It is so important to know that. Key takeaway here is just try to always look for a dress that tapers out at the bottom or flares out at the bottom or gets a little bit looser at the bottom. Those are great to give you a lot more shape. Some dresses are really easy because when you're out shopping, you can instantly look at a dress and see if it's going to give you shape or not, because sometimes dresses have shape. So if it doesn't have shape, if it's just a straight dress, try to stay away from something like that. Lean more towards dresses that have shape already, because it's just going to make your life so much easier to make you look curvy and just bring attention to your smaller waist. So tip number four is going to be one of my favorite tips actually, and I do this really often. If you really pay attention, you'll notice I really like to do this a lot, but wrap things around your waist. One thing about that that's really dope is it is really trendy in 2021 to have that like 90s look. Wrap things around your waist, just a regular flannel, a hoodie, whatever the case may be, wrap it around your waist and boom, you instantly look like you have a small waist and wide hips. It's amazing. I love this tip. One, it keeps you with the times. Yes, you're gonna look popping, you're gonna look trendy. And two, because it keeps you warm because of the fact that you're usually wearing a flannel or a hoodie or something like that around your waist. And if you ever get cold, you can take that off and put it on and duh, it keeps you warm. I love it because now you have this extra fabric here around your waist that is acting as a buffer to trick the eyes almost into thinking you have wider hips. So that's really nice. A lot of times by widening your hips, you're making your waist look a lot smaller. So that's just a win-win situation. And it's really cute. So honestly, it's definitely one of my favorites. All right, guys, for my fifth tip and my final tip, I actually briefly mentioned this in the last video that I did similar to this one, but I have some updates that I wanted to share with you guys, but shapewear, okay? I know that shapewear is not for everyone, and I know so many girls always complain and say, I don't like shapewear, it's uncomfortable, it makes my butt look flatter, it makes my chichos spew out on the top, and now I look even more unflattering. A lot of people just don't like shapewear, and I totally get it. I'm a big shapewear advocate because I love what it does to my body. It's honestly incredible, and if you find good shapewear, it doesn't have to be uncomfortable. And honestly, part of me feels like everybody who says that they hate shapewear, it's because they probably haven't found shapewear that they like or that actually gives them the shape that they're looking for. So I wanted to share some updates with you guys because I've been purchasing these so much within the last year, and they're so nice, and honestly, I just have to share with you guys. So these shaping shorts right here are from the brand Nautica. You can buy these at TJ Maxx, Marshalls. I'm gonna try to find them. Sometimes you can even find them at, I think Burlington has them. I always buy them at TJ Maxx, but honestly, I'm gonna try to link them here, or I'm gonna try to link some similar. I'm also gonna link the ones that I buy at Walmart and Target that I still use to this day. Why do I like shaping shorts? So for one, as you can see, they have these really thick band on the top, and honestly, this isn't the case with just these Nautica ones. Usually a shaping short is always going to have this. 9 times out of 10, shaping shorts all really look the same and they kind of do the same thing. So this basically serves as an underwear, right? But it's just gonna give you so much more support as just a regular underwear or a regular boy short because of the fact that it is high-waisted. So it is going to help give you that like gut support, that love handle support, while at the same time it slims your body. It keeps you looking and feeling really good, especially when you need it most under some jeans or under a dress or whenever you need support. These are going to be perfect. They're definitely the step up from your regular basic underwear, and they're going to give you so much more shape. These are going to be my recommendation for anybody who doesn't like shapewear or who struggles with, you know, finding shapewear to be comfortable. Get yourself yourself a shaping short because it's definitely an upgrade from a regular underwear. It just does wonders for your body beneath your clothing. I'm still really loving all of the shapewear that I showed you guys in my last video. So if you haven't seen it, go ahead and check that out. Still stand by it. Still love it a year later. I just wanted to share other recommendations for you guys as well, since I know some of you guys in that video were saying that you still don't really like shapewear like that. So, all right, you guys, and that is going to complete this video. So those are going to be my 5 clothing hacks and ways that you can really get yourself to have a smaller waist with clothing and make yourself appear a lot curvier. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful. And if you did, don't forget to smash that like button one time so that I know that you enjoyed it. And leave me a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite tip was and other videos that you might want to see from me. So yeah, you guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.